Hey, what's up, everybody? My name is Chris, and today I'm really excited to talk to you about how you can use Nemotron 3 Nano. We just launched this model today, and we have a bunch of different things that explain how we built it, how you can start to build your own Nemotron 3 Nano, as well as, of course, a comprehensive tech report and a white paper explaining what our Nemotron 3 family of models is all about. In today's tutorial, though, we're just going to focus on how we can actually use the model to do something. We're going to first start by checking out how to use it through an OpenAI API compatible endpoint. Then we're going to build some agents with it using LangChain. Let's just jump right on in so we can get started building with the model. All right, so now that we've got our notebook open, it's pretty straightforward to get started. We're going to run UV sync, and then we're going to make sure that we've selected the newly created VN for our kernel. We're going to make sure that we have our open router API key, which you can get by following this hyperlink. And then we're going to go ahead and set up our initial client. This client is going to point, of course, at OpenRouter's base URL, and we're going to pass in our OpenRouter API key. For our model today, we are going to be using the NVIDIA Nemotron 3 Nano 30B A3B model. This means this is a mixture of experts model with 30 billion total parameters and 3 billion active parameters. Let's start with a simple request and talk a little bit about thinking on versus off mode. Like previous models, Nemotron 3 Nano has two thinking modes, which is enable thinking true and enable thinking false. While we're in enable thinking true, we want to make sure that we set the hyperparameters temperature and top P both equal to 1. This is going to get us the best performance out of the model. What thinking mode does, of course, is let us generate these reasoning tokens. So as you can see, instead of just producing a final response, we're actually going to think about the response and then produce the. We also have reasoning off mode, or enable thinking false, which you can do the same way you would set thinking to true, but of course we're going to set this value to false. What this is going to do is skip directly to the final response. There is no thinking tokens required. This is really useful if you need shorter, snappier responses from your model, and you're not in need of that reasoning power. Something to keep in mind is that if you don't select a mode, that is the default, is going to be thinking on, or the idea being that if you don't tell it to not think, the model is going to think. Let's set up a simple LangChain agent to see how our model does. The first thing we're going to notice is that we can use the chat OpenAI abstraction from LangChain since we're using OpenRouter. We set up our model just as we saw before, noting that we're setting temperature and top P to 1 since we are not specifying the thinking mode for the model. We can invoke this and see that we get the response we'd hope for, which is hello from NVIDIA. Next, we're going to set up a tool. This is a simple DuckDuckGo web search tool. What this is going to do is let us search the internet for things related to our query. Next, we're going to create our agent using LangChain v1.0's real easy create agent function. We're going to create a system prompt, as you can see here. We're going to create a checkpointer, and then we're going to go ahead and create our agent, passing in Nemotron 3 Nano as the brains of the operation, our web search tool, our system prompt, and our checkpointer. And with that, we're good to go. We can run a simple query like, what is Nemotron Nano 9B V2? And we get a nice little report that tells us all about our previous generation model. Next, we're actually going to build a multi-agent research system. What this is going to showcase is one of the strengths of our Nemotron 3 series of models. The fact that they're built on a hybrid architecture of Transformer Mamba, as well as being mixture of experts, means that we can actually generate a lot of tokens very, very efficiently. So they're great in use cases that require these multi-agent interactions. Something else that's important is that the model supports up to a 1 million context length, meaning that even as many agents talk to each other, we're going to be able to handle that context. Let's look and see how we did this and then see the example. First things first, we're going to go ahead and we're going to create a search agent, a report writer agent, and a quality reviewer agent. These are using the same simple create agent that we saw before, and now we're going to wrap them into tools so that we can have our supervisor agent use them as tools. As you can see, this is fairly straightforward. We wrap it in the tool decorator. We have some logic that allows us to call the tool, and we're off to the races. Finally, we create the supervisor agent, and the supervisor agent is going to have access to each of the individual agents as a tool. The idea being here that instead of calling tools as tools, we're calling agents as tools. So this is our final report. As you can see, we did a nice little report on NVIDIA Blackwell GPU architecture. The big idea here is just that we are able to create a system where we're calling multiple agents from a supervisor agent, and this occurs very efficiently thanks to a lot of those decisions made when training Nemotron 3 Nano. That's it for this tutorial. If you want to learn more, again, we have a ton of great resources available to you. We're going to link those down in the description so you can check them out. We have some cookbooks that will help you deploy the model, as well as, of course, a technical blog, as well as a Hugging Face release blog. We have a lot of information that we're excited to share about this model, and we can't wait to see what you build with it. Thanks so much for watching, and have a great day.